Hello. In this video, we'll be discussing the LMR36015-Q1 thermal layout optimization on a two-layer board. I'm Sam Jaffe, an applications engineer at Texas Instruments in the WideVN Buck Converters and Controllers group. The LMR36015-Q1 is a 60-volt, 1.5-amp buck converter with a rated junction operating temperature of 150°C. Now, this is great elevated temperature for automotive applications and other high-temperature environments. We'll be evaluating on a 2.2-inch by 2.3-inch board with two layers instead of four layers to reduce cost. This layout is optimized for EMI and thermals, so if you want to learn more about the EMI, check out our EMI video. And for a deeper dive on the thermals, you can check out our thermal deep dive. First, let's talk more about the IC and the package. The LMR36015 is in a flip chip package, which is what we call HotRod at TI. This package has many benefits, including better EMI performance, intuitive pinout, reduced switch node ringing, and much more. But one thing this package doesn't have is a thermal pad. Typical parts use a thermal pad to provide a path with high thermal conductivity to let the heat escape the IC to keep the IC cool. But the flip chip ICs take a different approach. No thermal pad means most of the heat will escape through the pins of the IC and into the board. Flip chip devices have a direct connection from the die to the pins to increase thermal conductivity, and some of the pins are elongated to get more heat out. So the best thermal performance will be achieved by connecting the pins to large copper traces and polygons to allow the heat to spread from the pins throughout the board and into the air. Let's take a look at the layout of this two-layer board to see how we implement this technique. On the left, we see the IC pinout for reference and an image of the whole board. We also see the board zoomed in on the IC. The picture on the right shows where the heat flows. The P-ground pins are connected to a large uninterrupted ground plane so the heat can easily spread. The P-ground plane also has lots of thermal vias to spread the heat to the bottom layer as well. These strategies allow lots of heat to flow out of the P-ground pins. The second most heat comes out of the V-in pins in this design. The layout has a large hexagonal polygon for V-in which allows this heat to spread and dissipate. We also see polygons on the other pins. A ground has a moderately sized polygon, so some heat will flow from there. The other pins can be better utilized if better thermal performance is required. So let's take a look at the results. We have our board powered up to 12 volts in, and our board is here, running at 5 volts out, 1.5 amps out. Here's the board, and here's the IC. Here's the thermal camera, and here is the live readout. You can see the IC case top temperature is about 50°C. Which in a 22°C ambient room is a temperature rise of about 28 degrees. This, with a few calculations which you can see in our deep dive, means we can operate at about 115°C ambient. Now, a lot of automotive applications only go up to 105, which gives us 10 degrees of room to play with. So all of this on a small two-layer board. So just with a few layout guidelines, you can achieve excellent thermal performance suitable for any typical automotive application. For more information on the package and flip chip and layout guidelines, you can check out our deep dive. For more information on the IC, you can check out ti.com/LMR36015-Q1. Thank you for watching.